So I didn't exactly like participate in console war stuff when I was younger, but like seeing games I was interested in being like exclusive to a console I didn't have did make me a little salty. So I was a bit disappointed when I couldn't play Alan Wake because it was, I think it started only on Xbox. It came to PC at some point, or maybe it was on both. Either way, I didn't have a good PC. So basically it was not a game I could play. So I was a bit mad. I didn't complain about it on the computer, but boy did I want to play Alan Wake because it looked cool. So now I get to play Alan Wake because it looks cool. Let me make sure. Yeah, okay. I did a quick test. Everything seems fine. I do not want to continue the game. I did not play very far. Just a little bit. Enough to get into like a combat scenario. We'll play on normal. I think I remember. Actually, is nightmare is not even allowed. So normal it is. I remember, I think, hearing that like on higher difficulties you actually have more collectibles, because there's a gimmick to this. If you don't know about Alan Wake, we'll get to the gimmick.
Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer.
Oh. That is a scary stinger. A rider. Ooh, gross.
I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So, yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there.
That's a big wipeout.
I'd seen the hitchhiker too late. He was dead. I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again. Suddenly, his body was gone. I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
Oh, that's weird. Usually the look up option in games is like what determines whether or not you're controlled. No, this is good. Like, either up or down usually works when they tell you to look up in games. So the idea is that whatever you instinctively go for is what the default controls will be. So if you push up on the analog stick, that's just what's going to happen. If you push down to look up, that'll happen too. Usually it's not like a process of asking you a question.
The radiator had broken when I hit the hitchhiker. The car wasn't going anywhere.
Come on, that hitchhiker wasn't that heavy. And I guess it did kind of mess it up. What's the license plate? Also, what's in the back here? I like focus. It's a book by this guy named Alan Wake. Must be a pseudonym. I can't read the title though. Have just a lot. They are large books.
I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there. I was certain I had just driven from this direction, but now the road was blocked.
I'm certain of it. There, what? Must have been tired. All right, what am I doing? Okay, I'm sprinting. I'm sprinting. 35 miles per hour. A wacky bird.
bridge had collapsed. I'd have to find another way to the lighthouse.
But I found the collectible. I forgot about hearing about these. 100? That's not gonna happen. Pretty sure this is all chapter-based, so unless if I'm allowed to, like, replay chapters for collectibles. Like, obviously, if there's a replay chapter, is probably gonna be a thing. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe it's not that obvious. But, ooh, wait. Is that me? Have you seen this man? Does it look like me? Kind of. I look a little sad. Just like a writer would. It's a shadow man. Go.
You don't even recognize me, do you, writer?
Yeah, you're the hitchhiker I hear.
God. You think you could just make up stuff? Play with people's lives and kill them when you think it adds to the drama? You're in this story now, and I'll make you suffer.
Okay.
You're a joke. It would be a single readable sentence in your books if it wasn't for your editor. You'll never publish another one of your shitty stories. Because I'm gonna kill you.
It's not like your stories are any good. Not like they have it.
Damn, that is scary. A critic.
That's all you're good for. Just look at me.
Look at your work.
Your work is mid. 2 out of 5 stars. Didn't laugh once. QR code. Did they have QR codes back when this came out? That has to be, like, new, right? Gotta look up what the QR code is for. Cause I don't have a reader. I really need to get one.
You missed your deadline!
Oh! It all really is a nightmare for an author. Whoa. Well done! Try it again. I don't... Right. Kind of weird. It's also a little silly looking.
Hitchhiker was a character from the story I'd been working on.
See, he did recognize him. I like just dodge button. Because it's such a like limp dodge. It's like, more like a stumble.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
Well, it's scary when you're a tornado. Okay, I guess I need the bail. Okay, there's like a little cabin over there. I'm sure going over a rickety... Did I like run out of speed? Do I have like a small stamina thing? Rickety bridge is always great when a tornado's chasing you. Yeah, give me a minute. I'm tuckered out. I'm an author. I don't exercise.
This guy. Play Stewart, remember?
I don't.
Quickly, get inside. There's no time to lose.
Are you gonna shoot the tornado, Clay? That's not a good idea. The bullets will whiz right back. They'll like spin right back towards you. The tornado's too powerful.
Oh no! Stop! No! Damn it, die! No! No! No!
I was trapped. There was no way out.
What a neat little TV. Oh.
Die, die.
Yeah, it's not
die,
really that neat now.
Die,
oh.
Die, 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 die.
Conspiracy of faith. Tom the poet. It's spooky laughing. Don't want like a deer head to start laughing at me. Oh no!
It was a death trap. I had to get out.
How do I leave? How do I escape? Oh! What happened? I'm dying. I'll go that way. Yeah, no, I... Seemed like a good idea.
You are hurt. You should go into the light. You are only safe there.
Okay. Focus on the light. So light will heal me? Oh, look at that. I knew light was like the big mechanic in this, but I didn't realize it was so healthy for me.
I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
No.
Follow my light.
I like the way Alan said it. That was such a genuine, like, what are you talking about? It's like Marky Mark when he was asked if he was going to murder and kill that old lady, and he goes, what? No.
Darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing.
Yeah, but are there any thermostats? I want soup.
This way. There's no time. The hitchhiker has been taken over by the dark presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm.
Oh.
Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light.
Oh, thank you. God's flashlight. Appreciate it.
Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away.
Does this do anything? It looks like it's fizzling him. Oh, it does. I think that little ring is doing it. But it's very slow. I know, Yeah, okay. And then you do that and it goes faster. But there is a meter at the top.
Now the darkness no longer protects
well done.
Him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun.
God's gun. From the heavens. I appreciate it, God. Thank you.
Now you'll die.
Ooh. So would the only way for me to like focus fire is to, well, that's cool, that still stuns him. Kinda awkward to try to like aim. Ooh, tap, reload faster.
You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
Thank you, God. Oh, goodbye, God. Appreciate it.
A terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
Yeah, okay, so it will burn away the darkness faster. But I think like we actively have to collect energizer batteries. Get out of here. Oh, I thought you like felt it, your death. Oh, he found a way around. Do I do more damage when I need to remember about the tapping. Do I do more damage when I still, like, stun them with the flashlight? Because it seemed like, oh. I'm going to shoot these. I'd imagine, since this is supposed to be a dream, that I am most likely not keeping my infinite revolver bullets. I see the thermostat. Can I shoot the barrel? Whoa. The answer was no to barrel. Oh, I need to insert a battery! I forgot the dodge button for a minute. I'm assuming it's a waste to shoot at all if they are still dark. So I see my light is charging back up. I don't know if I can, if I necessarily need to use batteries except for like emergencies. Open. I could not see the circle button because the light was too bright. I'm assuming it's a very strong weapon. I'm going in here because there was a thing. It's mine now.
Just like me.
Eat flare. Yeah, basically as effective as I would have assumed. Now I'm invincible with only two shots of this. Are you okay? He's okay. I want to reload faster. I probably shouldn't spend too much time looking for the collectibles. I doubt they matter that much. I mean, I know there's a specific collectible type that might be more important. I went backwards. Yeah, I have like some kind of like mini stamina meter because I definitely run out of juice quick. Oh, it was a drop hazard. Ooh, look, a boat. Wonder if, like, in-game we're gonna end up making the same run to the lighthouse.
I can keep this up forever!
Well, I wanted to go explore the van, but I guess I won't. Okay. These barrels are very nice for me to know when the falling is gonna happen. Ran out of juice. Actually, I probably could have checked that van. I wonder if I should kill myself so I can check it out later. He is coming. Quick, before it's too late. Yeah, nice. Oh, Lord. The shadows, I'm too slow. I should have exercised more. Oh, because Alan needs to be awake.
Just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
Thank God it's a checkpoint.
Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Yeah, but with sure. The old man?
I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy. moments before he got eaten by a bear.
I thought the cars had brands in this. I also completely forgot to look at the license plate numbers, but it kind of looks like they all just don't have license plate numbers. You don't want a license plate that says Twin Peaks on it?
Alan, before I missed the shot.
Fine. I don't know. Oh, look, there's a
Hi.
Plane.
Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Main, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I could get an interview?
Look, Mr. Main, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
More like Pat, man your own business.
Very nice.
I want to go talk to this guy, though.
I got a couple of really good ones. I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got it.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word, and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you're relaxed and charged. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. I'm just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
I want to talk to this guy who's really mad.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Alan, we're here. Come on, let's get back to the car.
I want to talk to the other person. Could we have let the boat ride go all the way before we talk to Pat Main? Oh, look, the deer! I'm missing it! A lot of stuff here. Ooh,
come
a little
on,
bit of chain physics.
You get the full service here. I've made all the arrangements. I drive the car. I'll even carry the bags. All you have to do is drag your cute butt into the car and enjoy the ride.
Yeah, sounds like you've got a lazy bastard for a husband.
Yeah, but I got a thing for him. Come on, you lazy bastard. Let's go.
I don't know if he really has a cute butt. Maybe if he takes the jacket off.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stucky. He's waiting for us. I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes.
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave. I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the O'Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stucky. Carl Stucky?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment. I can't believe it. I've got all of your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
It's a pretty good reaction to that. Look how spooky it is back there.
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
Are you staying
right
by, Mr. Wake?
So much for a quiet vacation.
I'm having a conversation with Alan Wake.
How many, like, people really get this excited about authors?
Are you on your own, or is your wife with you? I can show you the town if you want. I get off work at 6.
Thanks, Rose. We'll be sure to keep that in mind.
She's like, damn, his wife is with him. Thought I had my chance. Look at these guys.
Do me a favor, Sonny. I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
I like these guys, but that picture's wild up there.
Drink them both up.
Is that the song?
Because we're brothers, don't think I won't murder you in your sleep.
It does that. Get stuck. Yeah, you need to give it a good solid whack.
Whack it.
Now that's what I'm talking about, yes!
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
I can, like, barely hear it. I think I messed with that audio a little too much. Let's put the music up. It's good. He loves. Look how great. He's having a great time. I'm gonna steal this. I hope you don't mind. It's a little spooky. You got like a log in your hand?
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am.
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find
you
Stucky
die,
to get the key
you?
And get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did.
You know, I mean, I was trying to hold back on saying this is kind of Twin Peaks, but...
Change the bulb. This is what happens when you get sloppy.
Oh, did we have no choice but to go this way? I guess obviously you could talk to everyone. Look at you just staring at me. Like you're a fan or something. I want to go into the staff-only room. I wonder, did, rural towns ever exist before Twin Peaks came out?
Let's do my rounds. Remind them to change their bulbs always. Stay vigilant, because darkness never sleeps.
Oh, it's like, okay, it's like an old lamp. I see it now. You know, it's a log or a pot. What came out first, Alan Wake or Deadly Premonition? I'm gonna leave. Okay, walking into doors. Tells me if they're locked or
Hello?
Not.
Hello?
What a... Like, barely even a knock.
Mr. Stucky?
You know, Stucky's in there, he's just a little... Oh,
Carl
hello.
Couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
Cameron kind of did like a little jig there for a minute. Like a juke
Cauldron
left
Lake
and right.
Is a special place. Very inspiring.
Toluca Lake? Again, Midtown's... Midtowns. Rural, like, towns never existed before Twin Peaks or Silent Hill.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This really ought to be fixed, and then I must remind Sarah to change the lights at the station. It's been too long already.
Oh, he fell asleep!
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
Splendid, splendid! Damn, hurt.
The Andersons.
Oh, wait.
They're local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
He was saying some weird things about a balloon and a spoon. I didn't mean to go too far.
I'll be heading back to work as soon as Dr. Hartman gets here, Rose. Oh, but I'm not looking forward to the poison we have at the Park Cafe.
Is that my wife?
Now this is what coffee should taste like.
Can I have a center sandwich?
So sweet. I'll swing by with a fresh cup later on.
Okay, I guess you don't want to say anything to me.
Will you be staying in town for the Deer Fest, Mr. Wake?
The deer is dear to me. The deer is dear to me.
I like those guys.
The deer is dear to me, my dear, in more ways than one.
Oh, dear. That's not really our festival anthem.
Could have fooled me there.
Well, I'm glad I stayed for that.
I had the keys.
Oh.
Alice was outside. I didn't want to keep her waiting.
But I decided to stand in the middle of the diner, just in case if I felt like self-monologuing again. I wasn't sure why I kept doing it, and why I kept saying I should go, but never actually leaving. Alright, let's go.
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Mission accomplished. The key, and the directions.
My hero.
I got it from a ghoul lady.
Some flashlights, just in case.
Thank you. I learned that those are important in combat. Who are you?
Hey, wait!
Oh, that's the actual guy that we were supposed to get the keys from.
Your keys!
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home, okay?
Okay, we can talk about this later.
Batman here on PBF Heaven.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
And now the weather. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks in the big city might want to look up every once in a while, see those stars winking down at you. It gets pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
How much did it cost to rent out this cabin? On like a nice small little islet? That's fancy. They die for.
It's gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
Gotta be honest. I think going out into a cabin in the middle of rural America. Maybe not the best place to go if you have a phobia of darkness. Maybe climbing all the way up here wasn't the best place to go when I had to get my wife into the house before the darkness came for her. Also, considering all of the light mechanics, but I knew it. I knew there would be a thing.
The
I'm focusing.
The cabin obviously got its name from the shape of the island. It looked like a giant bird leg. Alice had mentioned that the lake was a caldera. There was a dormant volcano under it.
Oh. I didn't know what a caldera was, but thank you. It said like Diver's Isle. What do you mean like Birdfoot Lake? I'd imagine if the cars were branded in the original that maybe they just didn't get a deal with the people again. I don't know if this is going to still have like Energizer batteries or if they're just going to be like off-brand. Well, I go, I don't know cars enough. I don't know if that, like, looks like a specific brand. or if it's like off model to a brand so they can't get in any troubles. Don't want no car troubles, you hear? This is like, this would be like a really nice cabin if it wasn't for the fact that problems are going to happen at the cabin. Like, you know, if it was just like normal cabin time, I'm like, yeah, this is a very beautiful, very pretty place. There's a well. I hope there's no ghouls in the well. Doesn't really look like there's anything in the well. I'm just saying, Diver doesn't look like a bird's foot. Camera's a little... like, I don't like how close it gets to me, but I guess that makes it easier for the shooting. When I want to, like, I just want to look at Alan's beautiful face. Can I jump? Yeah! Jump right into the drink. Honey, they call it Diver's Isle for a reason. Oh, that's it. The cabin's called Bird Lake. I get it now. It all makes sense now. It's a wacky jump. Take your time, honey. You only have the night to fear. Also, great to have a night phobia in a game very much associated with using lights. Well, not a phobia of night, just darkness, right? It's kind of the same thing. Examine!
The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again.
Oh, well, that looks important. But for later.
An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
Or right now. Mm-hmm. Okay. Doesn't take too many hits. Obviously, it would be an issue if things were axing me from behind.
Alice had told me about Cauldron Lake Lodge. The old building used to be a hotel. But these days, it was no longer open to the public.
Okay. I'll look around a bit.
Sure thing. Have fun.
Oh, I guess I'm not looking around for a bit.
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here.
Now I can look around. Like, having a phobia of the dark, do you, like, get just super stressed when nighttime is about to happen, even if you have a lot of lights on? I could imagine it being very stressful for the night to come. Despite having, like, any types of lights. I don't think there's really much for me to explore. I already went up there and got a thermostat. There might be more, but... I'm not expecting to get all 100. I've already probably missed like 25 of them, and it's just the beginning of the game. I want to go play with this. Rub my head against it. Nice. Yeah, this is how I play with wind chimes. Just rub my head against them.
Alice? Honey?
Take that, rocking horse. Look at that big old fish. Is there a photo mode? Can't believe they didn't add a photo mode. Every game needs a photo mode. I was hoping I could bash that.
A shoebox filled with books by Thomas Zane sat on the shelf. I'd never heard of him before.
I don't care where my wife is, I need this. Yeah, mess up the chairs. Yeah. Can't imagine she would have gone outside. The night's coming.
The old door had played a trick on me. Alice wouldn't have come out in the dark.
It didn't. Okay.
The Deerfest guests have already started to arrive. Just ran into one on the ferry. A famous artist, no less, but we'll see if we can rope him into an interview later on. Now, let's go to the phones. Caller, you're on KBFFM.
Hi, Pat. It's Rose.
Why, hello, Rose. What's on your mind?
I know who that famous artist was. It was Alan Wake, wasn't it?
My favorite. Well, Rose,
I just saw him at the diner. Oh, I am so excited he's here.
I'm sure.
That's a face of dying inside.
Folks, I guess the secret's out. This is Pat Main on KBFFM. And now, some music.
Great. So much for keeping a low profile.
Kind of seems impossible when someone has a stand-up display in the diner that everyone goes to.
The water was black. I couldn't help but imagine all sorts of horrors lurking in the depths below.
Might be gators in there. I don't think this would be like a gator place. I don't know where this is, like east, west. Probably not gator territory, which means only one thing can be lurking in there: bears. They hide in the water. I do like the narration of, "Damn, the door being ajar was a trick. I've been fooled. The door tricked me."
Alan, I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
I hope it's lingerie for me. Oh, there's that deer head.
Surprise!
Alice?
I thought this was the wrong room.
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Damn, Alice, you... Everyone keeps...
Hey, just hear me out. There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe... So now you want to get me committed?
No, it's not like that. That's not...
Oh, that spooky Alice... lady was there. Alice. Oh, twice!
Just don't! I don't want to hear it! God damn it, Alice! God damn it!
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
Oh, he, like, actually left.
Damn.
I thought he went to the dock. I didn't realize he actually bailed.
Alice?
Alice?
Alice! No! No!
Alice!
The cabin had gone dark. All the lights were out.
Alan! Where are you? Help!
Oh God, they're shadow birds!
All right, I'm coming!
No!
What the hell?
I thought they were just like normal birds, just like for spooky ambiance.
No!
What if I turn the generator on? I'll save you with the generator.
Stay away from me!
I'll be honest, probably should have just gone straight to her.
No!
Yep, maybe I made a mistake. I'm sure she's fine. I can't believe I already got the bad ending. I took too long saving her. Well, now with how long this has been,
Alice?
I feel like she's just...
Alice?
Felt like she was just joking. Oh my god.
Oh no!
Keep going, Alice. Wake up!
Alice?
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot.
I had realized I had gotten the bad ending by going to the generator instead of trying to save Alice immediately. And for that, I questioned whether or not I should restart the game. But I decided to move on anyways.
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either.
Yeah, I get you, Alan. I don't like his smug face. Me and Alan, we get each other. That really is the creator's dilemma, isn't it? I kind of figured it probably wasn't a great place to fall, but I don't know. I thought maybe it would be neat. I thought maybe there were things there.